Good morning, everyone, and welcome to our daily devotion insight. And this morning, I want to read a scripture to you taken from 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 20 to 27. All right? And starting from verse 20, here it says, "Yes, there are many parts, but only one body. The eye can never say to the hand, 'I don't need you.' The head cannot say to the feet, 'I don't need you.' In fact, some parts of the body that seem weakest and least important are actually the most necessary. And the parts we regard as less honorable are those we clothe with the greatest care. So we carefully protect those parts that should not be seen, while the more honorable parts do not require this special care. So God has put the body together such that extra honor and care are given to those parts that have less dignity. This makes for harmony among the members so that all the members care for each other. If one part suffers, all the parts suffer with it. And if one part is honored, all the parts are glad. All of you together are Christ's body, and each of you is a part of it." Hence, I want to entitle my devotion this morning as "Everyone is important." Everyone is important, all right? You know, every one of us, we all play an important role in the church. There are some things that only you can do, while there are some things that only I can do. Why? Because we are all unique and we are all special. We are all have different talents in our own ways. You know, I cannot force myself to do something that you are good at. And you cannot force yourself to do something that I'm good at. Each of us, we are gifted in our own special ways. Let me give you a simple analogy, all right? When we put honey, okay? When we put honey in our mouth, it tastes sweet, right? Why? Because the purpose of the mouth is to taste the flavor. That is the purpose of the mouth. But if we put the same honey, and we put it, this time we put it in our eyes, the honey can never taste sweet. In fact, it's going to be a bitter experience for us. Why? Because it's going to be painful, hurtful to our eyes. Why? Because that is not the purpose of the eyes. The purpose of the eyes is to see, not to taste the flavor. So, likewise, each one of us, we are unique in our own ways. Huh? Some of us, we are the mouth. Huh? Some of us, we are the eyes. Some of us, maybe we are the ears or the nose or the hands and feet. So, that's why we all have different roles to play in the church. However, it doesn't just stop here. With all the different roles that we have, it is also crucially important that we need to come together and work together for the common good. In other words, it's not only, you know, about that every one of us is important, but more importantly, all right, more importantly, using everyone's importance in order to achieve the one goal, that is to glorify God. Amen? You know, our God is a God of wonders. In all these variations, in all these differences, God can make something beautiful out of it. And that is the beauty of unity in diversity. And talking about different parts of the body, you might think that, you know, one part is more important than the other. Likewise, in the church, it may look like, you know, some people, they appear stronger, while some people, they appear weaker. But actually, we are on equal terms. Why? Because all of us, we are imperfect people. Nobody here can say that, you know, we are perfect and we can do everything by ourselves. All of us definitely have something that is lacking within us. Hence, we need one another. The stronger ones can help the weaker ones, while the weaker ones can help the stronger ones. For example, if there are no front stage people, you know, so-called the stronger ones, to lead the praise and worship session, okay? They will not have a wonderful time of praising and worshiping God together. Yet at the same time, if there are no backstage people, and these backstage people so-called the weaker ones, if there are no backstage people to manage the sound, the light, and the screen, the result will be the same as well. There won't be any wonderful time of praising and worshiping God together. And another example I want to give you, all right? If every one of us, we all become the ushers, so-called the stronger ones, all right? The ushers to greet the people. But at the same time, if there is nobody to go and clean the toilet, and these people are so-called the weaker ones, the church is going to be a place that is not so welcoming after all. You know, this principle is not only applicable in the church setting, but also when we are outside. When we are outside working or are studying in the school. Why? Because the church is not just a building. Rather, the church is the people. So, every one of us, no matter who we are, is actually important, all right? Because we all have a role to play in the kingdom of God. Amen? And when we play our roles with a great sense of responsibility and with a spirit of excellence, imagine what the outcome is going to be like. Only the sky is our limit. Therefore, church, let me re-emphasize again. Every one of us is important. You are important. I am important. Every one of us, we are important. And I can never do the work of the hand, and the feet can never do the work of the mouth. Let us learn to appreciate one another, be grateful for one another, and work together. And when we do that, there will be a sense of cooperation and unity among us as the church, as the body of Christ, that eventually leads to God being glorified. Amen? So, may you be encouraged by the word this morning, and I pray that may the Lord's favor be with you, and may His light shine upon you today. God bless you.